I'll pick the perfect time to start doing construction when I start recording. Hello, Internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. Today, I'm going back and doing another iteration of one of my favorite newest vlogs, and that is, of course, the Mystery Bag. If you hadn't seen the past two vlogs, I highly recommend checking them out. They are a lot of fun. But for those of you who just want to watch this one right away, here's the breakdown of how this works. I have a bag. I have a bunch of CDs in said bag, and I'm going to pick out 7 albums at random and show them off and talk about them. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, first one in the bag. This one. All right. Earth. These guys are awesome. They are the first drone metal band that I had ever listened to. The first album I ever listened to was actually their second album, and it was unlike anything I had ever heard. Back then, I wasn't really into drone music that much, let alone drone metal, but I had read about this band, and I knew that they were big in the Seattle scene. They were friends with Kurt Cobain, and they were getting their claim to fame around the same time Nirvana was. So after listening to a handful of their albums, I've been slowly but surely collecting their CDs. Then I stumbled across this one. This is actually technically a compilation. I think it's their first EP and then another album they did all on one disc. What I like about this album is it actually features some vocals by Kurt Cobain himself, which vocals weren't really a thing in their music. They've been a primarily instrumental rock band, but I like hearing their older material. I think that's their best time, when they were still really raw and really droning and heavy. And then their later material, they started straying away from the drone sound and started doing much more straightforward post-rock, post-metal. Still really, really good, but I've always preferred their drone stuff over their post-rock stuff. This was reissued by Southern Lord. They've put out some awesome metal records, and I have to thank them immensely for re-releasing these two albums on one disc, and I'm really, really excited to have this one. Okay, next album in the bag here. Alright, Jesu, Opiate Sun. I've made mention of Jesu in the past. I got their debut album, and I even made mention to this EP. This was the first thing by Jesu that I had ever listened to. Steve the Roommate was heavily influenced by this EP when he was in a rock band back in the day. He shared this EP with me because he knew I was a big fan of one of his songs called Shields, and he told me that when he was doing Shields, he was trying to basically do a reinterpretation of the title track Opiate Sun. So for the longest time, I've been wanting to get this CD, and because it's out of print, it was always really expensive at Amoeba. It's only 4 songs, but Amoeba was charging $12.99 for it, and I never could bring myself to spend 13 bucks on 4 songs. After going back and forth for a long time, I actually was gonna go in and buy it, and I happened to stumble across the album in the clearance section for a mere $1.99. I'm incredibly excited that I found this for so fucking cheap. It's a fantastic EP. It's probably one of my favorites, if not my favorite Jesu album that's out there. They're such a cool band, they are well worth checking out, and I totally recommend checking out this particular EP. Alright, the bag. What else do we have in here? Let's do this one. Alright, Floor. Yet another Steve the Roommate recommendation. As I've talked about in the past, he has a tendency of sending me songs that he likes and wants me to check out. And I don't even remember which one it was on here. It was Sister Sophia. He sent me that song. Boy, the traffic is really obnoxious this episode. I'm a sucker for heavy music that's also melodic, and this is just that. And it's not melodic in a corny, whiny sort of way. These guys are a sludge metal band that just so happens to have a little bit of melody in their music that makes it a little more listenable rather than aggressive. So after hearing that song, to me, I had to buy the CD, and I did. I found it for, I think, like $5 online, which I was really stoked about. This is a cool record, really cool band. Highly recommend checking them out if you haven't already, particularly if you're a big fan of sludge metal. Reaching in the bag, number 4. Awesome. Billy Bragg. This is, God, one of his many, many works. He's got quite the extensive discography. My first exposure to Billy was actually when he collaborated with Wilco on the Mermaid Avenue sessions. After listening to those, I'd been meaning to pick up a Billy Bragg album, but I never knew where to start just because, again, he has so much stuff out there. But what made me pick up this one was, I was watching an episode of the Gilmore Girls, and there's an episode where they're at a party and the song From Red to Blue is playing in the background. I immediately recognized his voice, and I couldn't really put my finger on it at the time, and I had to think about it, and finally I was like, it's Billy Bragg! Of course it's Billy Bragg! And after watching that episode, I immediately sought out this song, and I found that it was on this album, and so I went from there and picked up the album. I haven't really listened to this yet, I actually just got it, but I love From Red to Blue. I love how slow and emotional it is. I'm assuming the rest of the album is gonna be kinda like that, but I'm sure it's gonna be very political, just because that's who he is, folk punk artist. William Bloke, Billy Bragg, he's great, I love him, I'm really excited to listen to this.
Does not explain the change I see in you, the way you've drifted off from red to blue.
Okay, next in the bag here. Oh, there we go. This one. Ooh, alright. This is Have a Nice Life. These guys are memed pretty hard on the internet, and that's how I found out about them. Their first album, Death Consciousness, in particular, is the one that's memed quite a bit. My first playthrough of them, I actually was kind of disappointed, and I think I attribute that to the fact that I was expecting to hear one thing, and I was disappointed when I heard something else. But I never really gave up on the album, and I would go back and forth on it, and one day I was listening to it, and it finally clicked. So after that, I've been a big fan of this band, and I actually stumbled across this album on a whim in the metal section of all places. This is their second album. This one's actually not nearly as appreciated, but considering that I found it and it's a physical copy of theirs, I had to get it. I don't even think their first album was released on CD. I think it's exclusively digitally and vinyl. I love how creepy this cover is. It's like something out of a cult, which is a pretty adequate description of how their music sounds. It's really grim and despairing and dark. If you haven't checked out this band, highly recommend it. It's really cool, despite the fact that they're kind of the butt of a lot of jokes on the internet. They're still a really solid band. Next up, in the bag here. Oh, here we go. Yet another meme. Sweet Trip. Kept seeing this album pop up, especially when talking about shoegaze music. Because I like the genre so much, I decided to look into it, and what I heard was shoegaze music, but just in a very, very different way. It's not uncommon for shoegaze to be incorporated with electronic music, but when it's incorporated with electronic music and glitch music, that's when you have something different. So immediately after hearing this album for the first time, I was pretty blown away by it. It's just such a noisy, chaotic album, but it's also really poppy sounding. I don't really know too much about these guys other than the fact that their music is just really, really solid. All I can say is if you're a fan of shoegaze music, you should definitely look into this one. It's a really unique experience, and it really goes to show that the shoegaze genre is still alive and well, and people are just playing with it to no end. Okay, last one from the bag here. Let's go with this one. Alright, The Lilies. This is a pretty unique album here. This is called Exame the Photon Band. These guys have really changed their styles over the years. Their first album was very similar to My Bloody Valentine, and then they've later started doing much more traditional alternative rock. But this one, they kind of do a mixture of dream pop, kind of shoegazy, and space rock. I found this album in the book Gimme Indie, which is what I use for any of my indie rock findings. I reference that book anytime I'm looking for something new. I had found it at Amoeba, but they were charging $25 for it. I wasn't gonna pay that, but that also made me curious about this album. I always feel like if an album is charged at that high dollar, it's gotta be good, or it's rare, or both. So instead of buying it at the store, I bought it online for significantly cheaper. I really, really like it, and I love how abstract the cover is. As you know, I love spacey music, and I love ambient music, and this definitely fills the quota for both of those. It's just super cool and nice to zone out to. They're a really, really solid band, and now I'm on the hunt for their first album, which is even more expensive and I think a little more rare to find. You are loved Okey-doke, internet, that does it for me. Hey, if you have any albums or bands or songs you want me to check out, leave a comment down below, and if I like them, maybe I'll include them in the vlog or even put them in the mystery bag. But until then, this is Olin from What I'm Listening To, signing out. Goodbye.